Hey everyone, Gabby here, and in this video we are talking about calendar within Canvas. So on the left-hand side, once I'm logged into my Canvas account, I have an icon specifically dedicated to my calendar. So let's click there, and it's going to take us to the agenda view because that's just where I was last. So in the agenda view right here, I have a list of all my courses, assignments, discussions, anything that has a date with it. That could be a due date or an event with a specific time. So I'm actually going to switch to the month view because this is a cool way to see all coursework, all assignments, discussions, events, anything like that. So you'll notice that I have two different colors. The colors match with this key on the right-hand side. So I've got this grade course for elementary engagement with Canvas. That's the stuff that's all due Wednesdays. Then I've got some other random ones for my sandbox course. So I can see that this special guest at 2:15 today, that's a specific calendar event. And you'll also notice that each of these items have an icon that matches with what they are. So for example, this one has a calendar icon because it's an event. This has a paper and a pencil because it's an assignment. And this one has the word bubble because it's a discussion. So that can be helpful to teach kids, you know, what's upcoming and what it means. All right, so this is the month view. This is the week view. Now, something to view here. You'll notice as I scroll down, I have to scroll a bit to get to these ones because what time is the due date? 11:59. So be conscious of that as you teach students how to navigate their calendar if they go to the week view. Because if the due date is at 11:59, they will need to scroll all the way down to the bottom to view it like that. So if you've got younger students, consider changing the due date to like 8 or 9 p.m. at night so that we're not encouraging them to stay up late. But you will notice I've got that 2:15 special guest right here, right in smack dab in the middle. Okay, so how do I get stuff to show up on my calendar? Biggest question we get. So let me go back to the month view. And these are assignments. Because they have a due date, they show up on my calendar. If it doesn't have a due date, it won't show up on the calendar. The other thing is, what about those events? Okay, say you've got a field trip, a special guest, or a substitute. Go click Create New Event. And you've got three tabs. You've got event, assignment, or appointment group. So event, let's title it substitute. And let's say that I'm going to have a sub next Friday, day before Halloween. And it's going to be from 8:30 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. And the calendar I want to send it to is my sandbox course. Hit submit. And now I've got my substitute right here. Now, what if I accidentally put it on Friday and I meant to do it on Thursday? Simply click, hold, and drag to where you want that substitute event to go, and it will go there. All right, now let's go to create new event, and we can click the assignment tab. Here's where I could do a quick assignment. So let's just do math homework 3.3. And I'm going to say that it is due on Thursday, and it's for my sandbox class, and it's going to go in the assignments group. I am going to publish it. If I click more options, it's going to open up this assignment to really get deep into it. So this can be super helpful if you want to start from your calendar instead of starting from your course module or assignment section. So I can write my description here where I couldn't do that with the quick add. And then I can come down and change those settings if I want. So I'm ready to save it, save and publish. Now I've got that assignment, math homework 3.3, right here on Thursday as well. Now I can go to appointment group. I can title this, let's just title this group project fossils. And I can have students sign up for the group that they want to be in if they want, or I can divide them into equal slots of 30 minutes for them to sign up for their appointment. So I can also limit each time slot to one user, so only one person can sign up during that time. And then I can allow students to see who has signed up for time slots that are still available. So if this is a group project, I'm probably going to want to put 4, maybe even 5, just to be safe, so that each member of the group can sign up for that time. All right, then I can hit publish, and then that's going to allow students to sign up for appointments in my class or for presentations or anything like that. I'm going to go ahead and click cancel on that. And the other thing is you can click calendar feed right here, and this you can copy and paste this into Google Calendar, and it will sync your events and homework assignments, anything like that, to Google Calendar. So if you like to have it all in one spot, you can click that, paste it in your Google Calendar, and then it'll be there for you. All right, so that wraps up Calendar within Canvas. You know, calendar is a really great way for us to communicate with our kids as well, where we can start to train them on how to stay on top of their work and stay organized. But then for us as a teacher, it helps us keep things organized too and keep things concise and consistent with our students. So I really like to use the calendar, and I really do prefer the month view because it's just a quick snapshot and takes me directly to what I need to get to. And then a really easy way for me to add events and things so my kids know exactly what to expect. So that wraps up calendar.